Okay, I'm Dr. Paul with Chiropractic Personal Injury Marketing, and we just wrapped up shooting some marketing videos with Dr. Matt. And the importance of video is 50, you gotta remember, 55% of how we communicate is visual. You're gonna have more people look at a video than anything else. And also what is important, what I like to do, is I like to have the doctor in the video because it personalizes it and it helps to increase the trust and confidence with the doctor. And so we just finished the doctor. You can see here we have Matt. We like our doctors to look like a doctor. So he has a white coat on, you know, looks presentable. So as an idea, how did it go? How did the videos go?
Paul went really well. I mean, it takes some work, but Paul definitely knows all those psychological points to hit. He knows the key words to say, and really importantly, what not to say. And that's was probably my difficult part, is Paul kind of kept me on track of what not to say. And to really get me to speak just to what a patient's looking for. Definitely went over some things that, you know, I really just never considered because I just kind of had my doctor hat on all the time.
Right.
And I just
Which
kind of,
common.
Yeah, I just wanted to use my big words
right.
and my terms. And I realized, you made me realize that that doesn't mean anything to patients. In fact, it probably scares them away.
Right. Yeah.
Probably scares them away.
How about content? And one of the things we're real important on is the motivating factors of whether it's a personal injury patient or a personal injury attorney, making sure that we're saying the right content. So how did you feel about the content that we covered?
The content was exhaustive, if that's the best word. I mean, it was overloaded, and definitely the way you're going to speak to an attorney, which you've shown me and you've taught me, is that it's going to be much different than going to speak to a patient. And you know, the attorney has some motivations, which I didn't realize, which I guess I knew, but I just didn't really realize and have it at the forefront. And the patient has some motivations, and they're completely different. And I have my own motivations, but you know, I want to do it the right way. And what Paul showed me was, you know, how to approach both, you know, both of those users, the attorney and the patient.
And we talked earlier today about the two categories. One is the very specific marketing, what you do first, second, third, and why. You remember covering that?
Yeah.
And the common sense approach to that.
Right.
Did that make sense?
Yes.
When we covered what to do first, second, third, and why.
Yeah, it did.
And then we simplified personal injury case management.
Right.
By covering, you know, back to the 80% of a chiropractic office and not trying to be everything to everybody.
Right.
So we kind of covered that too.
Right.
To have that help with simplifying and going, hey, this is manageable. I can put this together.
Yeah, that's what I really realize is that this is manageable. That, you know, I can take a more simplified approach based on what you've taught me and what you're going to continue to teach me on how to, you know, document, how to show, how to approach the personal injury attorneys and really give them what they're looking for.
Yeah, and we covered we cover not only the marketing step by step, what works, what's most effective, least effective, and why, and what order, but also the clinical components,
right,
which is so important. So anyway, Dr. Matt did a really good job with his videos. If I can help you with your chiropractic personal injury marketing, give me a call. You can go to chiropracticpersonalinjurymarketing.com and you can actually get some free some training on there. Or you can also go to chiropracticpiworkshops.com and get some personal injury training there. This is Dr. Paul. If I can help you, let me know.